Well, hello everybody, my name is Ateya and welcome for joining me today on the authentic from scratch crawfish etouffee by Chef Gason. I would like to thank him once again for this wonderful recipe. I did my own things to it, my own little twist, so you guys definitely have to check out at the bottom of the screen in the more info box of how I did it my way and towards his way. But everything was still good. You have to make your base, which is your roux, from scratch, which I really enjoyed here. I want you guys to come over here and take a look. Come on, come on, come on. Take a look at how good this roux looks. Look how good it looks. Wait till you guys taste it. Oh my goodness. So I am using my larger cast iron pot, which is a 5-quart. It's a must have for doing this type of work. So I hope you guys enjoy this authentic crawfish etouffee by Chef Gason. It is so good. Let's get into the video. You guys don't want to miss it. Let's go. Well, hey everyone, please see the more info box for changes in this recipe. Let's first get started. Right now, I do not have the fire on. So right now, add 1/4 cup of peanut oil to a cast iron pot or any pot that you have. Next, let's take 4 tablespoons of unsalted butter. Mine is by Lando Lakes. And now let's turn it up to medium-high heat. Straight from the south with thoughts of moving north, and I can teach you how to. So once it get hot, this is what we're going to do. It's going to start bubbling. So now let's turn it down to medium heat. So now let's apply the 1/2 cup of flour very, very slowly. Now this shortcut, you do not want to shortcut this process because this is the base of your dish. So please take your time. So right now we're just gonna keep adding in the flour and stirring really, really well. And I must say, I was so proud of myself making my own roux. I was just so happy. When you do it from scratch instead of using, you know, like the cream of mushroom, to me, I felt so much better. So I'm really learning a lot. So once again, I'd like to thank Chef Gason from New Orleans for this great recipe. And on top of that, I host contests. But back to this, they crab potatoes and boiled shrimp. Did I tell you my peanut brittle was a symphony brownie? So now we're going to keep applying. If you don't mind right now, you can already have your whisk out. Because we're after this process, we're going to whisk. Beauty expert out, baby. Heard of one night stand. If not, I suggest you check for me. Lately, I've been grinding, delivering videos with perfect time and hustling hard like the death. And it's looking good. You're going to start seeing the color change. And if you notice, and I think you're definitely going to be so happy that you did this process as well. It's going to be such an amazing dish when you finish. You are now tuned in to Smooth Complexion. Miss Ateya, have you seen her? Better known as the Mac Dot, I'm Maybelline teacher. If this is your first. So we're done. So we're going to just keep stirring really, really well. We're not going to waste any time. And right now, you cannot leave the stove. You have to stay there for a good minute until you get that nice, pretty color for your roux. Triple A should get you looking right, ladies. And I am the one and only Rigoletto Rockwell. So now let's take a whisk. We're just going to whisk our way on through. Now, right here, it's totally up to you on what color that you would like your roux base to be. I'm going to have mine to a light dark roux color. You're my darling, darling baby. So again, you're going to be here a while, maybe 10, 15 minutes. So this is the color that I wanted. So now we're going to the next step. Now right here, I changed things up. Chef Gason has 3 yellow onions. If I were you guys, 1 to 2. 1.5 to 2. Again, he had 6 stalks of celery. I'm not a big celery fan. But I did at least 3. But I will definitely do them smaller the next time. 1 bell pepper. And you're going to take some minced garlic, 6 cloves. We're going to mix that in really, really good. See, this one, I feel there was too many onions. That's why it shouldn't be that much. So just make sure it's really getting in good with that roux. Because after this, once you put that lid on, it's going to like really get softened up and it's going to get right. So don't worry about it. The Mac Dot, I'm Maybelline teacher. If this is your first time visiting, prepare to get your feet wet. You are now tuned in to Smooth Complexion. Oh, what? You still here? Want more? I got that. Today I'm talking about food in my broadcast. And it's smelling so good. So now we're going to apply the lid and just let it really simmer really good until it's tender. So now everything is done. That will take like 7 to 10 minutes, if long. It's totally up to you. Now we're gonna add the seafood stock. Again, he said you can use water, chicken stock, but I found the seafood stock. So now we're gonna add the Worcestershire sauce. We got some bay leaves, and bay leaves are so cute. And we're gonna add some thyme. There's nothing else more for me to really say. So head over to youtube.com/ATEY AAA. Should get you looking right, ladies. And I am the one and only. So we're gonna stir that really good, and we're gonna bring that to a ball. And I'm gone. And right now, you can take the time out to taste it. If you need more salt and pepper, add some Tony Saturi. Please make sure you taste as you go along in this process. And right here, add your salt and pepper. Straight from the south, with thoughts of moving north, and I can teach you how to flat iron that hair with no burns. I give you my time. So right now we're gonna lower it to low and with it uncovered for 30 minutes, and we're gonna stir occasionally. So right here, take your time. So right now, as you can see, it's been going a while because your roux is looking good. So 30 minutes later, you want to apply your crawfish. Your lemon juice, which I will squeeze some of that out in a second, you're going to see, and add your green onions. Now for me, I did not add parsley. For me, parsley is like way too strong, like parsley, fresh parsley. So if you want to add the parsley that's in a can, in, you know, in the little bottles by McCormick, do so. Right here, I'm adding the lemon juice. But I added the parsley at the end to up on my dish. So it's totally up to you right now. But I took that out because parsley is really, really strong to me. So me and parsley just do not get along. Not the fresh parsley. So now we're going to stir this really, really good. Right now you can taste, add more seasoning. But right now this base is looking absolutely beautiful.
case you check for me. Lately I've been grinding, delivering videos with perfect timing, hustling hard like the definition on my triceps. You know me, I'm the lady with a crap infected, and if you notice I got a smooth complexion.
So we're gonna add the green onion. We're gonna stir that on up.
If this is your first time visiting, prepare to get your feet wet. You are now tuned in to smooth complexion.
And this can cook for another 15 minutes, and I'm gonna the heat up.
If this is your first time visiting, prepare to get your feet wet. You are now tuned in to smooth complexions. There's nothing else more for me to really say. So head over to youtube.com/ATEYAAA. Should get you looking right, ladies. And I am the one and only Rigoletto Rockwell.
So once we turn this up to medium high heat, you're going to add the last 2 tablespoons of unsalted butter. Right now, taste everything, make sure it's okay, add more salt and pepper, tone it saturated, whatever seasoning you want to add to your crawfish etouffee, because we are done. So you can let that simmer for another 10 minutes or so, and it is ready to go. Look how good that looks. So definitely check at the bottom of the screen of the changes that I made in this recipe. But this is good for everybody. It's delicious. So now it is time to eat.
Just to teach you fly, winging it sometimes, but hey, the sister tries. What you need to know about who you know what he has got it.
So now this is one of my plates that I got from Sawgrass. We just got a new Sawgrass, and I bought 2 brand new plates because I love those plates. So I bought 2 of those, and I know right now my rice may turn to pink. I'm so sorry, but don't worry about it. It'll turn back white. I can do math. So right now I'm ready to apply my crawfish etouffee on top, and it's looking good, smelling good. Once again, make sure it's to your liking of taste, and I'm gonna add that crawfish etouffee right on top.
Miss Ateya, have you seen her? Better known as the Mac Dot, I'm Maybelline teacher. If this is your first time visiting, prepare to get your feet wet. You are now tuned in to smooth complexion.
And see right here, I'm going to take the dry parsley flakes, add that, and we are done with this dish. So everybody, this is it. Check out the pictures.
My peanut brittle was a symphony brown as you can't be. Taste my pepper steak, have breakfast with me. During a Super Bowl impression, guests with buffalo wings from me.
So once again, everyone, thank you for joining me for this authentic crawfish etouffee recipe. Make sure at the bottom of the screen you check out the changes that I made for my liking for this recipe. Again, if you want to follow Chef Gason, he's on Twitter for all his great recipes and all those pictures he has every day. Check him out. So I will definitely see you guys on the next video. I love you guys, and you have a great day.